And Texas and Michigan are built very differently. Now, I don't know about some of these other teams. I know Florida State's resume and Ohio State, they won a battle against Notre Dame, and Penn State, I believe in, and everything. And Georgia gets the benefit of the doubt against some of those other teams. But Michigan and Texas, they've proven it at the line of scrimmage. Michigan and Texas, those two teams, they would be tough to beat for Georgia. Really tough to beat. And by the way, both of those teams can play defense and they can cover. And I would assume that they wouldn't let Brock Bowers in the fourth quarter of a tie game run butt naked across the middle of the field. What are we doing? Butt naked, by the way, it means open. That was not a literal term, folks, right? Like, obviously. It's just a term like we use in football spaces. Like, hey, you know, he's butt naked. He's wide open. Brock Bowers was wide open running across the middle. Wide open. How does that happen? Someone's going to slow him down, and then Georgia's going to have to lean on the other elements of their team, and those other elements are not what they've been over the last couple of years. And that's why Michigan and Texas, they take me up to the first two spots. You look at those two teams, and they are really, really good, and they are really dangerous. Michigan is a boa constrictor. This is a team that moves slowly. They move methodically. It's not explosive. It's not flashy. It's death eventually and inevitably. That's what it is. It's like being in a small cage with a boa constrictor. You will eventually die. And they're better this year than they have been over the last two. Their defense has yet to allow more than 7 points. And I get it. Who have they played? I understand. They've allowed 13 points all year outside of garbage time in the fourth quarter. They gave up a touchdown to Rutgers on their first drive, and then two field goals versus Bowling Green. That's really it. Their first game against East Carolina, they scored the first 30 points. Their second game against UNLV, they scored the first 35 points. Their third game against Bowling Green, they scored the last 24 points. And in the fourth game against Rutgers, they scored the last 31 points. In the fifth game at Nebraska, they scored the first 45 points. Like, good luck with Michigan. I'm just telling you. Again, not flashy. Who's stopping that run game? Who's stopping them? I don't know. Maybe Penn State. Maybe Ohio State. I don't know. Nebraska was the number two rush defense in the country coming into this game this last week. They were allowing 46 yards per game and 1.8 yards per carry. And Michigan ran it 51 times for 249 yards, 4.9 yards per carry. Good luck. Good luck with Michigan. Just like, man, this team looks good. And by the way, Texas looks great too. And all offseason, we had this goal on this show to not talk about Texas until they were real. Well, guess what? Texas is real. I said, I'm not going to talk about Texas until they've done something. Well, now they've done something, and then they've done something again. This Texas team is so different than what they've been over the last couple of years. You see, this is the juxtaposition between Georgia and Texas. We feel like Georgia, and we give them the benefit of the doubt, and they stay in the top spot in the AP poll, I believe. And it's like, yeah, but they got a lot of holes. And Texas, it's like, well, we're going to see. We got to wait and see. And all of that narrative is because of what happened in the past. It's based on previous seasons. It really is. It's not based on the games of what we've seen this year, because this Texas team is really good. My concern with Texas was always that they play down to the level of their competition. In large part, they do that because they weren't great at the line of scrimmage. Because greatness at the line of scrimmage allows you to beat bad teams week after week with very little pressure, effort, whatever you want to call it. That's why the games with Michigan are not close. That's why Bama rarely, if ever, loses to a bad team. That's why Georgia in the last few years rarely, if ever, even plays down to the level of their competition. They crush bad teams because they're great at the line of scrimmage. Now, Georgia's in these weird games where it's like, man, you're sleepwalking through the game. This is the narrative that we've been seeing or what we have been seeing with Texas over the last few years. Why? Because Texas wasn't good at the line of scrimmage. Now, I can't believe I'm saying this, but Georgia's the one that's not good at the line of scrimmage. We're seeing that in the numbers and the data. Texas is good at the line of scrimmage. And guess how I know? They don't play to the level of their competition. So it doesn't matter if it's on the road against Baylor. They crush them. Now they welcome Kansas in. This is the prime moment where I'm like, oh, this is such a Texas game. It's the week before Red River. They get Kansas, the perennial basketball school. And I'm saying like that from their perspective. That's not what I'm saying. It sounds like a shot against Texas, and I'm not taking Kansas, and I'm not, because I love Lance Leipold and I love their team. I was really bummed when Daniels didn't play in this game. I'm sure they were as well. But this was the classic look ahead game, and Texas didn't look ahead. Why? Because they're great at the line of scrimmage. They play really good defense and they can run the rock. So guess what? It's going to be hard to beat them. Even if you're good, much less if you're bad. The last two games, they beat Baylor 38-6 on the road, Kansas 40-14 at home, and rolled up 600 yards doing it, by the way. 300 passing, 300 running. After Red River, Texas doesn't have a ranked opponent on the schedule. I know they got to face K-State at home and TCU on the road. TCU doesn't look, you know, all that tough. Texas Tech at home. Tech is struggling this year. Texas has, if they win Red River, they've got the cleanest path to the playoff of anybody in the country. Maybe outside Georgia, because I don't know what the SEC is this year. Kidding me, LSU? How is LSU still ranked? I digress. Maybe Wednesday. Texas is for real. Texas is this year what Georgia has been over the last couple of years. Great on defense, consistent effort, great at the line of scrimmage. That's why I don't expect them to lose some weird game. Whereas Georgia might be in some of these weird games, even through a bad SEC East, because they're not great at the line of scrimmage, which is wild. It's blowing my mind, but that's what the data is saying. And that's what the data is clear with.